Simon, can you explain why there has been a call to weigh containers?
This comes out of a number of incidents over the years in terms of ships breaking, container stack collapses, and port incidents as well, where it's been shown that the container weight has been different from that declared, and that has at least contributed to those incidents happening. And a good example of that is the MSC Napoli 2007, when that ship actually broke up, and in the subsequent investigation it was found that 20% of the containers were away from their declared weight by at least 3 tons, and overall all the containers were 320 tons over what the declared weight was, and that resulted or was a contributing factor to that breakup.
How easy is it going to be to implement container weighing logistically?
In the early days, the thought was that the ports would offer this as a service, but the actual obligation is on the shipper to provide the VGM. And so the discussion in the last year or so has been around how the freight forwarders and the shippers are going to provide the VGM. In reality, whilst it is the shipper's responsibility to provide that, the first practical opportunity to get that VGM is at the port. There are opportunities to do it either via weighbridges or different methods prior to the port. And it's important to say there are two methods allowed within the regulations. Method one, which is where you put everything into the container and then weigh the complete container. Method two is where you actually take all the elements that you're going to pack into the container and weigh them individually first, and then you put them into the container and add that to the tear mass of the container itself. So method two is the only practical method really in obtaining a VGM prior to it getting to the port.
Okay, and how will the new rules be enforced?
Here in the UK, it's the responsibility of the MCA, Maritime Coast Guard Agency. They are the people who will enforce the new rules, and they are working out and establishing the requirements for those rules. So within the actual amendment itself, there are no specific requirements around the accuracy levels required, etc. And the MCA, and we are involved with our other ports representatives and other people who are offering weighing systems in defining that for the UK. Once that comes out, then there is a good chance that that will be adopted around the world in other territories as well.
So who holds ultimate responsibility that the container is weighed correctly?
The regulations are very clear. The responsibility for obtaining VGM is with the shipper. Now the shipper in this case is going to be the person or entity that's named on the Ocean Bill of Lading. So it's very clear that it is their responsibility to obtain the VGM.